Few weeks ago, we were able to edit images with the help of AI by using Gemini 2.0 image editor. But now, Elon Musk's Twitter, which has the Grok AI, allows us to edit images with that. So just go to the home interface of Twitter and you'll be having the Grok app. Click it. And in the Grok app, you'll be having the edit image option. This particular edit image feature can be accessed through your mobile's Twitter app also. There will be a small brush-like icon like this in the mobile phone, and you can just click that and upload your images just through your mobile. So let's see what editing features it can do. So I will just click this and let me go with the normal one. Here I'm having an image of a car, which is red in color. I will just ask it to change the color to purple. All right, and send it. So this is the output that I get, and this looks splendid. So as you can see here, this is a quite tricky image because this not only has the car color as red, but it also has a reflection which is red. So the AI must change the car color along with the ground reflection. And Grok has generated two images and it has been spot on as well as in the reflection. And another great thing that I noticed about Grok is that it is able to generate two image output. Whereas I guess Google's AI image editor was able to give us only one output. And here we are having the download option and we can copy the image or even post it as a tweet. Some additional features. And apart from that, here you're also having the edit icon in case if you want to edit any one of these images. So I will just click on the edit. Okay, and let me just go and type convert this into a monster truck and let's see what it gives us. That looks good, like especially this part here you can see, right? This, I don't know what you call this, this metal portion is exactly similar to this car. So this hasn't randomly generated any purple monster truck, and it has in fact exactly cut this particular portion of that car and has generated a monster truck. So that's amazing. So let's just go with another prompt now. So here I am having a pink color sofa. All right, I will just open this particular thing, add this in a living room. So in case if you are an architect or an interior designer, in case if you want to see how this looks inside your home, you can just try this. So this is the output that we are getting, and that sofa image is exactly been embedded over here. And I like this double sofa. Yeah, this is the original image and it has done a pretty good job. Another thing that I noticed about this edit image feature is that I guess this doesn't allow multiple images to be uploaded. For example, if I select this and if I'm going with these two images, like I click this and I press shift and click this, here you can see it only accepts single image upload. So I guess you cannot upload two images and ask it to, like, you know, create or combine both the images. For example, if I even like upload this two images, the edit image is going off blur. So only after I remove one image, like only after I remove one of the images, it's coming back. That's a disadvantage over here, because in Gemini, we were able to upload more than one image over there. So let's see what it does with text over the image. So I will just upload this photo of a t-shirt and change the t-shirt text to Elon Musk, something like this. So this is the output that we are getting. We have two Elon Musk over here, and it hasn't modified any of the other parameters in the image. So it has done quite a good job over here also. And final one, let me go with a black and white image and test if it can convert it to color. So here I'm having a black and white image and I'm just going to put colorize it. That's it. So that really looks good, but there is an imperfection in the second image. Here we are only having one Statue of Liberty, and I don't know from where this got two Statue of Liberty in the second image. And another thing is, in this image I'm having here, like, I guess this is a fountain, like two fountain structure, but here you can see I'm only having one fountain and there is a pond in this fountain, but here I don't see any pond. It has just replaced that with the trees over there. But apart from that, it has done quite a good job. All right, this image looks like 90% accurate. So this is basically how you can edit images, and there are a lot of other ways you can just try it out in Grok AI. I hope you have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.